So we are done with theory of section 7, 7.1, section 7.1a and section 7.2 along with schedule 1, schedule 2 and schedule 3. Some questions we have to discuss again. Example 45, Ram has received a sum of 5 lakh rupees from his employer on premature termination of his contract of employment. So, you know, VRS kind of thing, VRS voluntary retirement scheme, alright. So my I'm taking retirement before my I'm terminating my employment before retirement age. So my employer is giving me 5 lakh rupees as a termination fee. Okay, now this is service provided by employee to employer during the course of employment, which is covered by schedule 3 of section 7 subsection 2. So taxable or not taxable? Not taxable. Negative list, not taxable. Example number 46 is deleted now because that section itself is amended, so no need to read that section. Okay, that was on section 9.4, it is deleted, so don't read this section. Illustration: salary paid to partners by partnership firm is liable to tax, liable to GST or not? So it's not liable to GST because service kind of contract that partner give to partnership firm. For partner, this is a business and this is just apportionment of profit. Okay, so therefore it is not liable to tax. They are saying it is just merely an apportionment of profit. Next, there are two types of directors we have in a company. Alright, directors who are employee and directors who are working at an independent capacity. So who are the employee directors as per Companies Act? So whole time director and executive directors, these two directors are employee directors. If it is employee directors, will there be tax? Answer is no. Why? Hello? Will there be GST? Because it is employee to employer during the course of employment. But independent director, non-executive director and managing director, these directors are not employee of the organization. They are working in their independent capacity. Because they are working in their independent capacity, there are two distinct persons, and then there will be GST. And yesterday only we have discussed, in case of director to company, services provided by director to company, it is covered by section 9 subsection 3, notification number 13/2017, reverse charge mechanism. So who will pay tax, director or company?
Company.
So it is chargeable and it will be, tax will be paid by company, not by the director. Am I clear? So this table also you should remember, okay, just for your understanding. Next, this point is not important. This 9.4 points which are related to 9.4 are not important because 9.4 itself is amended now. Okay, next, distinct person. What I told you about distinct person as per section 25, that if branch is in one branch is in Maharashtra and one branch is in Kerala, so these two branches, although they are legally same entity, but in GST law it will be treated as distinct entity. Then I gave you our example, our science division, our class commerce division and our professional division. Okay, these classes have three division, no? Science division, commerce division and professional division. If each division takes separate registration, if each division takes separate registration, then in GST law it will be treated as a distinct person, and then services given by commerce division to professional division will also become taxable. Hello? Legally you cannot provide service to yourself, but in GST it is possible because each registration is a separate SSC. You understand like that? If I take four registration, that I am not one SSC, then I am a four different SSCs. Are you getting this? And if one SSC gives service to another SSC, there will be tax on it. So this is what we have to understand. So look at the example, it will be more clear through example. CMA Ram, that is me, okay, practicing cost accountant, has a registered office in Chennai. Chennai comes in which state?
Tamil Nadu.
Okay, he has also obtained registration in state of Andhra Pradesh. So two registration, Tamil Nadu registration separate and Andhra Pradesh registration separate for branch office. So what will happen now? CMA Ram shall be treated as a distinct person in respect of registration in Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. So is Tamil Nadu branch giving services to Andhra Pradesh branch? Still it is taxable. You will say, sir, it is not taxable. No, they are same. They are not same. In GST law, it is distinct person because each registered person is a different person. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is how it is. Next. This is related to registration. We will discuss in registration chapter. Messrs. C has three branches, A, B and Z. In different state, A in Telangana has a run out of stock and B from Andhra Pradesh transfer excess stock. Stock transfer, taxable or not taxable? stock transfer taxable or not taxable? Taxable. It was written in schedule 1. Stocks transfer, branch transfer is taxable because this branch and this branch is treated as a separate business entity. Okay. Gift not exceeding 50,000, not taxable. Exceeding 50,000? Fully taxable. So here gift value is 75,000. Tell me what will be the answer? Entire value is taxable. Entire value is taxable. Okay, next. Agent to principal, principal to agent. Taxable or not taxable? Without consideration. Agent is giving goods to principal, principal is giving goods to agent. Without consideration. To pass on ITC, it is taxable. So let us take some example. Mrs. P Limited, registered person located in Cochin. Cochin comes in Kerala. Alright. So P Limited, registered person located in Cochin and having go down in Cochin, transfer the goods to clearing and forwarding agent located in Chennai. So they have transferred goods. They have not sold goods. Okay. Such activity of transfer shall be considered as supply of goods even if there is no consideration for such transfer and liable to GST. Am I clear? Why? Because now that clearing and forwarding agent will sell in the market and therefore he should have that ITC component which was available with me. Are you getting this? So principal is giving goods to agent. Okay. While giving these goods, principal is going to charge GST on it. The moment principal charges GST, agent will get ITC. Are you getting this? Yeah. Same example. Paul and Company engages Honda Cars Limited as an agent to sell cars on its behalf. Honda Cars Limited has supplied 50 cars to his showroom of Paul and Company. So you understand, no? This Honda, Hero Motor Corp, they are having these franchises here. Alright. So main company is not selling cars to these dealers. And then dealer will put that in showroom and then people will come and buy. So who will sell final? So dealer, this franchisee dealers, they are going to sell cars to final consumer, yes or no? So output GST will come to dealer, but input tax credit is available with main company, manufacturer. So when main company transfer this car to showroom, there has to be tax obligation on main principal, so that agent or that dealer should get ITC out of it. Am I clear? Look at this. Located in Chennai, supply of car by Honda Cars Limited to Paul and Company will qualify as a supply and the same is leviable under GST. The purpose here is to pass on ITC. Okay, we are not punishing them. We are just passing on ITC from Honda to agent. Am I clear? Yeah, principal to agent. Next. Mrs. M Limited, being an garment manufacturer, appoints Mr. Ram as the agent. So your institute loves me a lot. Okay. Who stores garment manufactured by M Limited and sends to dealers when M Limited asks Mr. Ram to do so. Is it a supply? So now it is warehousing. Okay, we are putting it into warehousing. So yes, transfer of garment from M Limited to Ram is a taxable supply under GST, although it is without consideration. Okay. And GST will be leviable. Why? Because again ITC has to pass on from one person to another person. Okay. Importation of service from related party only. From? Without consideration, only from related party, taxable in the course of business. So Apte and Apte Limited, located in India, holding 51% shares in Wilson Limited, USA based company. So 51% to become related party, you should hold more than 25%. So is it related party? Yes. Okay. Wilson Limited provide business auxiliary services to Apte and Apte Limited, will be treated as supply or will not be treated as supply? From foreign we are getting service, importation of service from related party without consideration, is it a supply or is it not supply? It is a supply as per schedule 1, as per schedule 1, section 71c, schedule 1, section 71c. Okay. Why? Because this is import of service from related person, yes or no, and this will be taxable on RCM, this will be taxable on RCM, reverse charge mechanism. I hope you understood that section 7 at least, yeah? So many questions are there on section 7. Next. Sparsh Limited of Mumbai imports business support services from its head office located in USA. Head office and branch office. Related party?
Yes.
The head office has rendered such services free of cost to branch office. So they are not charging any consideration. Without consideration means which section should hit your mind? 7(1) C, import of service from related person in the course of business. Supply. Are these many conditions should come to your mind? Is it import of service? Yes. Is it without consideration? Yes. Is it from related person? Yes. Is it in the course of business? Yes. Is it supply? Yes. Okay. Can I go ahead?
Yes, sir. Yeah?
Next, a shopping complex owned by Messrs. X Limited and Y Limited. At a later date, Messrs. X Limited sold his share in shopping complex to Z Limited, and hence ownership is not transferred to Z Limited, but only share in a property is transferred to Z Limited. Is it a supply of service?
Yes.
Yes, it is a supply of service. Ownership is not transferred. Like when you are not transferring title in immovable property, then okay, it is supply of without transfer. You are giving right without transferring title. Right, no, transfer of right to use goods without title. So it is service. Okay. Next. Mr. A provides machine to Mr. B and he permits Mr. B to use the machine. Not own the machine.
Use.
So use is what? Service or goods?
Service.
It is supply of service. Mr. A provide machine to Mr. B and he permits Mr. B to use the machine, provided that Mr. B for machine after 2 months, when the property of goods will be transferred to Mr. B. So it is not, it's not used. Right now he is using, but after 2 months he will pay full money and that time property will be transferred. So future date. So it is supply of goods. Only use if it was there, then it was service. But here title will be transferred at future date. So higher purchase kind of transaction, taxable as a goods. Okay. If a residential premises is used for residential purpose as well as some business purpose, it is said as activity of leasing of residential complex and will be covered under definition of supply. And it will be chargeable for tax. Residential, only for residential is exempt. Yes or no?
Yes.
Residential, for residential as well as commercial, that means it is taxable. Okay. If you use for mixed supply, that we are going to discuss now, mixed supply. There you will understand. Next, job work. Any activity carried out on the product, whether from bringing change in the product or not, will be considered as the processing of the product. Job work. Job work is what? Technically, they are talking about job work. Job work is what? Supply of goods or supply of service? Job work. I told you, I gave you but an example. Supply of service. Okay. Job work, it will be called as supply of service. Mr. A, trader of steel article, purchased steel bars of 10 meters for 1 lakh. He gave this steel bars to Mr. B, job worker. Okay. So somebody bought 1 lakh rupees steel bars, and those 1 lakh rupees steel bars is given to some Mr. B. What is job of Mr. B, this job worker? Cutting that bars in small, small pieces. Okay. And Mr. B charge 20,000 for his job work charges. Yes or no? So you gave me big iron rods, I cut it into small pieces and I am giving you back. Yes or no? So is it supply of goods or supply of service? Supply of service. And only 20,000 will be taxable in my hand, because I am not giving that iron bars to you. I am giving my labor services, and for that I charge only 20,000. So taxable. 20,000 taxable. Okay. Next, Crown Beers India Limited supply raw material to job worker Karina Limited for manufacture of alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Mind you, alcoholic liquor for human consumption, sale of alcoholic liquor human consumption is not taxable under GST law. Sale, okay. Other activities may become, like transportation of alcoholic liquor may become taxable. Marketing of alcoholic liquor will become taxable. Only sale of alcoholic liquor for human consumption is not taxable. Okay. After completing the job work, the finished product of 5,000 beer bottles are returned to Crown Beers India Limited, putting the retail sale price as a 200 on each bottle, inclusive of duties and taxes. Inclusive. Whenever they give inclusive price, we have to compute by dividing it, its number. It's like if I say my 10,000 rupees is the inclusive of tax price, so we take 100 plus 18%. Yes or no? So this is how inclusive of tax price is computed. That valuation question we will do. Inclusive. So this 200 rupees includes all things. Tax and everything is included in this 200 rupees. Karina Limited charges 100 rupees per bottle as the job work charges. What is the consideration for Karina Limited? 100 rupees as a job work charges for what? Of carrying out intermediate production process of alcoholic liquor for human consumption from Crown Beers India Private Limited. Find the GST liability if rate is 18%, and when I say rate is 18%, 9% CGST, 9% HST in the hands of Karina Limited. So they are just simply saying 5000 bottle, what was the consideration charge by Karina? 100. If you can use Kelsey, so 5000 into 100 will be 50,000, 50,000 multiply by 9%. 5 lakh, this will become 5 lakh. 5 lakh multiply by 9%. 45,000 CGST, 45,000 HST, total liability 90,000. Is it difficult?
No.
Sir, but bottle price was 200. At what price main company is selling bottle, that is none of your business. At what price Raymond is selling this shirt, that is none of your business. For putting buttons, how much are you charging? 20 rupees per shirt, then that is your consideration. In previous question also, iron bar was worth rupees 1 lakh. We did not consider 1 lakh. We consider only 20,000 as my consideration. Am I clear? Job work charges are taxable in the hands of job worker. Okay. Next. Sale of office computer or furniture. Office computer or furniture. Is it supply or not a supply? Why? Is it deemed supply? No. It's not deemed supply. It's actual supply. 71A. Why 71A? This is business and furtherance of business and for consideration. 71C schedule 1 we apply only when we donate laptops or donate furniture. Hello? Without consideration. Yes or no? So this is supply under which section? Under section? 71A. Because there is a business and there is a consideration. Am I clear? Yeah. Next. Free samples freely supplied to others are also supply of goods. Free, 71C. Why? Because I am giving you as a free sample, but on that I have taken ITC, so I have to pay tax. So free samples are taxable. 71C. This is 71C. Okay, next. Mr. Raj purchased a car for business use. Car. But car for business. I told you, on car we don't have ITC. And after 1 year sold a car to dealer for 2 lakh. Will the transaction be a supply of GST? So the consideration shall be supply of goods even if credit is not claimed. Because here it is not transfer of motor car for personal use. It is actual sale of motor car, and that is business motor car. That is actually it is sale. Okay. Actually it is sale of motor car, and that to business motor car, therefore it is taxable. Consideration of 71A. Business asset for consideration. Business asset for there it doesn't matter whether you have taken ITC or not. Hello? Alright. Directly taxable. Any sale of business asset is directly taxable if it is for consideration. Am I clear? Yeah? Next. 71A. Next. Mr. A is engaged in a business of transportation of passenger. Now, transportation of passenger means you are running your car on Ola and Uber basis.
Yes.
Okay. For these people, ITC on car is available. Okay. This is in chapter now, next chapter, input tax credit chapter, but you should understand. For normal people, ITC is not available on car, but for passenger transportation, its business itself is a passenger transportation. So Nita Volvo, will they get ITC on cars? Yes, cars and bus, obviously. Ola, Uber drivers, will they get ITC on cars? Yes. Yes or no? Passenger transportation people will get. So if you are Indigo, on whole aircraft, you will get ITC. Okay?
Yes.
Right? So, they have got this ITC. He provide vehicle for the marriage of his accounts manager for free of cost. Okay? Is it a supply of service? Yes. It is a supply of service, but no GST is payable, provided business is not claiming ITC. So what they are saying, provided business is not claiming ITC, that means if business claims ITC, then it will become taxable. Without consideration supply, you need to check whether ITC is taken or ITC is not taken. If ITC is taken, then it is supply. If ITC is not taken, then it is not supply. And if it is a supply for consideration, then don't check ITC and all. It is for consideration or supply for consideration, business asset, by default it is taxable. Am I clear? Pakka?
Yes.
Chalo, aage chalte. Padho tum log, you will understand. Alright, you read these examples at your own. If you get any doubt and if you are not clear with the examples, please bring it to me. There are 200 plus examples. Okay. Mr. X is engaged in a business of selling furniture. He organized function in his house. As a result, he used business furniture for the function. Business furniture for the function. Will he pay? Will he charge any money from it? No. It is a supply of service. Since it is supply of service, no. Why? We are assuming that since there is a no consideration and hence no GST will be levied, provided business is not claiming ITC. So they are saying it is not a supply, provided they are not claiming ITC. If they claim ITC, then you understand? So I can write two answers. No, yes, it is a supply leviable to GST, provided they have claimed ITC. Now they are writing negative language, therefore they are writing they have not claimed ITC. Am I clear? Okay. Next, Messrs. X Limited provide car to one of its director for personal purpose and charges fee of 30,000 per month. Charging, it is a business and they are charging money. Charging money, that means it is a supply of service. Okay, it is supply of service and the same is taxable. Here you should not think about whether they have taken ITC or not, because there is a consideration involved. You are actually charging 30,000 from someone. Taxable. Okay, next. Hey Prabhu, how many questions are there? A director takes a computer to home for private use. Allowed? Hai? Can you take computer for personal use?
No.
No. So it will be treated as supply, provided they have taken ITC. Okay. The computer is not a business asset. Computer is the company's business asset. Is it a supply of service?
Yes
or no? Yes, it is a supply of service. GST is accountable on the use of computer based on its cost, that is open market value or cost price of the computer. However, if the company choose not to claim input tax credit on computer purchase, the private use of the computer will not attract GST. Very simple, no? Same thing they are writing again and again. Okay. A director uses company's car for family outing. Company's car for family outing. Is it a supply of service?
Yes.
But if they don't want to pay tax, then don't claim
ITC.
Okay. X Limited and Y Limited are related companies. So they are related parties. First, they have clarity that they are related parties. Y Limited uses X Limited business asset, namely a large format printer, to print high resolution architecture plans for its client. GST is accountable on the use of the printer based on its cost. Why? Because it is a related party transaction. One related party is allowing another related party to use my asset free of cost. Services provided by one related party to another related party without consideration is there in my schedule 1. Yes or no? Okay. Because we are assuming they have taken ITC on that machinery. They have taken ITC, but then they have written. However, if X Limited choose not to take ITC, it will not become supply. Okay. Next. Rawan, oh, my friend. Rawan and company partnership firm decided to dissolve a partnership firm. I told you, can you close business without paying GST?
No.
No, you have to pay GST first, because closure of business is also taxable supply. Yes or no? Because you have taken ITC. ITC. Okay, so goods left in stock, taken over by partners, taking over of goods by partner will be considered as a supply of goods. Since business is not continued further and the ITC was claimed. Obviously, ITC would have claimed. Okay, so by default here ITC is assumption. Next. Will you please do this? Yeah? So many small examples are there. Allow me to move further for a syllabus and use all these questions. If you are confused, then let me know. Let me see if we can take directly some syllabus from it. Pause kar do na isko.